Hello everybody, welcome to the Knives Save Lives channel, and I just thought I would do a video on some utility knives. I was watching a video just the other day and saw a pretty neat utility knife that one of my friends here on YouTube has, and I just thought I would show some of the ones I have and maybe compare a few points on them. I'll start with the most interesting one here. And I suppose this is some type of a kitchen knife or whatnot too, but it is the deal that I got it in said something about it being some type of utility knife, and I thought, well, that's interesting. It's got this sheath. You slide it in there. Well, it's kind of a trick. Here, hold on here. Okay, so you put this knife in here. I don't know. Anyway, you're supposed to be able to put the blade in there and it's supposed to lock. And from time to time it kind of works. I don't know what the deal is with it now. But anyway, it's got the, you know, kind of a sheep's foot type design to the blade. Sharpen it up pretty sharp. It does work fairly well for kitchen work. For a pretty thin blade. Handle's not all that great necessarily. The trying to put the thumb on the back of the blade, it's not quite as functional as it could be. It's got a ventilated sheath. This sheath is kind of interesting. You could take this and put it in your pocket and likely be okay to carry it. Let's see. Okay, see, there you go. There, it's locked. Oh, you can still get it out of there if you try hard enough. But it's definitely odd. I've never seen anything like that before. Okay, moving on. And I haven't used this for a great amount of work. Mostly just kitchen stuff. And then moving on. I've covered these three knives before. This is the quote-unquote Jeep knife. It's actually got about the most ergonomic handle out of any of these. It's rounded, it's got some curvature for your fingers up here. It's pretty nice for that. The lock is the horrible thing. This thing just, you know, it really doesn't lock. You can jam the lock over and it'll stay locked. But then you got the problem with trying to jam it back over to get it unlocked. The grain on the handle is pretty nice. I actually bought this for like $6 or something like that. My father-in-law had one just like this, and he had me fix it because there was the pivot pin had come out. It had the female piece but not the male piece, so I scrapped one of my other knives and fixed his for him. And I thought it was a pretty nice little knife, and I saw this one down at a store, department store, for like $6. And I thought, well, that's probably worth $6. It's got its issues for sure because of the lock. Pocket clip kind of sticks up a little too high and kind of digs into your hand some. Other than that, it's really not a bad knife. But there's that. And actually, this type of the blade being secured in there is a little better than some that I've seen. There's the ones that have like a button that you push down and then you pull the blade out. I've always had those come out while I'm using it, and so I don't like that kind very much. I think Super Knife makes theirs like that. These are kind of heavy. I'd probably say this is like at least 6 ounces or so, probably something around there. This whole knife weighs like that much. It's kind of ridiculous. The difference in weight. It might weigh less than that, but not much. Now this, on the other hand, I don't even have a blade in it right now. The blade that I took out of it is actually in this knife here. This is a Craftsman. I always wanted one of these. I wanted one for a long time because I really like the wood grain stuff that it has on it. And actually I had bought one at a point in time, and I ended up being a sap and giving it to a friend that I worked with, and he didn't have a good box cutter knife or razor knife or whatnot. And this thing It's about the heaviest damn beast ever. Really, if you're thinking about it. I mean, if this like the only knife you carry, maybe you wouldn't have a problem with it. But, I mean, this certainly weighs more than any of these here on the table. I don't even know. This might weigh about the same, maybe a little more. And probably, I don't know, it's hard to say. But this has been kind of fun to have. I've used it on some masking jobs and working on vehicles and stuff. And it's been a pretty decent knife. I mean, it's pretty functional. The blades always rust in here, and they rust like crazy. Just from sitting, if you know, if there's any kind of moisture at all, those blades rust. I mean, it's not this that's actually rusted, although technically it is now. It's been impregnated with rust or whatnot. Most of this will wipe out, but some of it will remain. But I've had this for a couple of years. It was on sale for like $10 with a sheath, and I thought, well, that's worth $10. I could get one of those. So anyway, there's that. And then here's the Sheffield. And technically this is made by Sheffield. If you noticed when I opened it, it has that S there. I'm pretty sure that is for Sheffield. This one also has it as well, as you can tell. And I've actually used this one a lot more than this one. This here is, I've had this since I was doing drywall, and I've also had the blade since then, too. I've used the same blade in multiple knives. This is probably the best out of this lot, I think, at least for these folding ones goes, and this. it has the aluminum handles, which are a bit lighter, and it does have a ton of steel on this thing too, which is, I don't think, necessary. These are kind of nice because you can use the butt end to hammer out, like, say, taper's mud out of, like, light switch boxes and stuff like that. I used to have to do that when we were masking off houses when I was doing drywall and stuff, and they worked rather well for that. They'd always get gunked up with the mud, though. And you'd have to kind of wipe them off or whatever. They'd just get covered, the blade and everything. This one I use with an Irwin blade. And most of them I do use with an Irwin blade. You can actually see that I've sharpened this one. And these are bimetal blades. And I've used this same blade in multiple knives. And only this side of it in multiple knives for probably about the last 7 or 8 years. At first, when I started doing drywall, I would go through a package of these blades of the regular sort that you can find right here in this one. I would go through a package of those because they'd just break and break and break in about a week. I'd go through like 2 blades a day, a lot of the times 2, 3 sometimes. And it was just getting kind of expensive, having to buy these things all the time. And I found these Irwin bimetal blades. They said that they were unbreakable. Well, that's not true. They are tough steel, and they're fairly flexible. The tip always ends up seeming to break off, which is a common problem with any kind of steel, mostly it seems. But the rest of it's held up good, and I've used the same blade a lot. I mean, inside of work and outside of work, I used it every day for years, and just works great. So, if you're going to buy one of these knives, get you some good blades for it. Don't sit there and throw your money away on them. And that's probably one of my biggest pet peeves of these kinds of knives, is they're so disposable. You know, it almost takes the art out of knives. You've got a replaceable blade, so, you know, people start to realize, oh, well, I don't have to know how to sharpen things. You know, it's kind of a crutch that people use using these. And, you know, you can go out and buy you a pack of blades that are going to break and go dull and whatnot. Or you can get something, you know, and have one blade and that be the only one you ever need. Now, I don't know if I would use this knife for everything that I would use this knife for, but I probably have. But I would rather probably beat something like this up just because It's cheap. I paid like $8 for it. It's nothing too fancy. So they're nice to have. These pocket clips come off almost every time on these knives. I don't know how many I've had of these, and these stupid pocket clips always come off. But anyway, moving on to the next thing. This is something interesting. This was actually gifted to me by my father-in-law. It's like a, like an advertising knife. Capital Automotive Supply. And it says, phone 888, Boise, Idaho. Kind of weird that it only has a three-digit phone number. I don't know why it would say that. But anyway, I'm from Nampa, actually. And this down by Boise. But this is kind of an interesting functioning knife. And it kind of makes me think of a utility knife, which it may or may not be. But it just rotates. This rotates. Then you flip this around. And it covers the handle. And actually, it's got quite a bit of meat left on this blade. It's in a bit of rough shape. Probably needs sanded down to remove some of the rust. But it says B&B, St. Paul, Minnesota. And I've actually seen knives like this on occasion that other people had, but I never had one myself. And it was just an interesting thing. I like unique items like this. So I've hung on to this for a while. And actually, he passed away just recently, so it makes this even more special. So pretty neat little tool. And then moving on to one of the last items you'll see here. This is something kind of funny. I actually found this at a little mom-and-pop shop here that has some necessities, you know, the beer and cigarettes and ice cream and diapers and condoms and all that kind of stuff, and a little bit of hardware stuff, and they had this. I can't remember. It's like $3 or $4, and it was just really cool looking. It looks just like the bigger models, and it's got this little teeny blade in there. And it's reversible. I believe I've taken this apart before and actually found that blade is reversible. I don't know where you'd get refills for it or if you can. But it was just kind of a unique little knife. I like miniature things. Miniature things are pretty neat. I don't really use these all that often, but sometimes they do come in handy if you don't want to damage the nice edge on your everyday carry pocket knife or something. So, pretty fun to have. It says Basix on it. I actually have two of these. I bought one and then my wife gave me one. And this is the last one out of the series here of these knives I'm going to show off today. This is a Lutz 82, I guess. It's a fairly heavy knife. It's pretty well rounded in the most of the areas of it. And it actually is a pretty nice knife. It's kind of a higher end one. A utility knife, and I've had this since I was doing drywall. I used it a lot. I actually bought one for everybody on my crew. I can't remember why the occasion was, just was in a good mood or who knows what, but I bought one for everybody, and I've just had it since then, and it's just worked really great. Got a lot of use out of it. You can see where the paint's peeled back from the tip, that it's been used quite a bit. It is fairly heavy, but you know, sometimes there are jobs where a knife like this is just better suited for. These are nice because of how much of a grip that you get on it versus say this little Sheffield here. And this has a pretty good grip on it, but this is quite a bit more full. And it's a little bit easier to hang on to. You can put your thumb up on the back of this here. You can move your hands forward up on there. You can kind of move back. You can just go all the way to the back if you want, if you got to stretch and reach to cut something. It's a pretty nice knife to have. And it's just been a real functional tool and companion for a lot of work that I've done. As you can see, it's still got quite a bit of the mud left in it still. But it just adds to the character, I think. And yep, it's made in Taiwan. Yep. Yeah, I thought it might have even been made in the USA, but nope. But anyway, yeah, that's pretty cool. I like having it. It was actually a promotional knife from a company that drywall outfit I worked for, did business with. It was their sheetrock supplier, so. But anyway, there's that. There's all my utility knives. Well, at least the ones I can find for right now. Because trust me, I know I have more. But anyway, because I just never get rid of knives mostly, unless it's a gift to somebody. But there you have it. I just thought I would do a little video on some of these utility blades. Hopefully you found it enjoyable. If not, sorry for wasting your time. But thanks for watching, and leave your comments below.